Why does my Microsoft account have two passwords? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. You have one email address that you use to identify yourself to Microsoft. It's your Microsoft account. As you might expect, it has a password or some other form of authentication. It might be what you use to sign into your PC, for example. And yet, in some cases, when you use that email address to, say, read email, you might need to use a completely different password. Buckle up. This one is really easy to get confused with. We normally think of a Microsoft account as being a Microsoft-supplied email address and the credentials associated with it. You use the same credentials to sign into your email as you do to sign into other Microsoft services or your computer. The Microsoft account I use for many of my examples is askleoexample@hotmail.com. Your Microsoft account is both an email account and an everything else Microsoft account. You use the same credentials for both because it's a single account. Very simple and, thankfully, the most common. Now, things can get a little confusing. For example, I just created a Microsoft account using my Gmail email address. And to be clear, I'm using Gmail as my example here because it's most assuredly not Microsoft, but any email address that is not a Microsoft-provided account will actually qualify here in what I'm discussing. Now, my Gmail account has its own email address, say askleotest@gmail.com, and of course its own password. This is what I use to sign into Google services and what I use to read email sent to that email address. When I used that email address to set up a Microsoft account, I was asked to specify a new password. Now, I could have used the same password as I did for signing into Google, but that's bad security. That's password reuse. It's the very definition of password reuse. So I specified a different password. The result is that it kind of sort of appears that this email address, askleotest@gmail.com, now has two different passwords, one for Gmail and one for Microsoft. That's the thing to remember, though. These are different passwords for different services. When signing into Gmail and Google services, use that email address and the password associated with the Google account. When signing into Microsoft and Microsoft-related services, use that email address and the password associated with the Microsoft account. It's exactly like using your email address as your user ID on any other service. For example, if you set up a Spotify account with that email address, then when signing into Spotify, use that email address, but with your Spotify password. Microsoft is just another service where I happened to use my Gmail address as a user ID. Of course, even though that's probably a little confusing, there's more confusing to come. Let's say your Microsoft account uses a non-Microsoft email address as its identifier, as I've just used askleotest@gmail.com to identify my Microsoft account. Now, let's say you're configuring Outlook, any version will do, to access your email. It asks for your password. Which one do you specify? It's Outlook from Microsoft. So do you specify the Microsoft account password associated with your email address? But it's your email from your not Microsoft email service, Gmail in my case, that you're trying to access. So do you specify the password associated with that email service? The answer, of course, is the second one. But to understand why that is, we need to pay really careful attention to what it is we're asking for and what it is we're being asked for. In this case, we're asking an email interface to access our email, to access the email for the Gmail account. I would then need to specify my Gmail password. That we happen to be using a Microsoft program to access that email, has no bearing on which password we use because we're not signing into a Microsoft service. We're signing into Google service. If we were using a completely different email program, say Thunderbird or EM client or something else, it'd be clear. Gmail address, Gmail password. Signing into Outlook, Gmail address, Gmail password to set up that account. Use the password for the services you're attempting to access. The Microsoft password for Microsoft services like OneDrive, Office, or signing into your PC. And the Google password, or your third-party password, for Google services such as Gmail or Google Drive or YouTube or others. This honestly is why I really recommend setting up a dedicated Microsoft email address to use for your Microsoft account. It avoids this situation completely. Microsoft account, Microsoft email address, Microsoft password. It's all the same. If, however, it's simply too late, or you decide you really want to use an email address from some other provider as your identifier for your Microsoft account, well, then you'll just need to be aware of exactly what service it is you're attempting to access when it comes time to provide the right password. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/178789. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.